Shetty. For since past 1 year, I am working with Elite Infotech. Prior to that, I was working with iGate Padni and Infosys. This is my third organization.
So let's start with contractor consumer BDD approach. You must be knowing about AngularJS, right? A bit knowledge about AngularJS? Everyone is having a bit knowledge. Okay, it's okay. But first we will start with what is AngularJS. AngularJS is a JavaScript framework for which is maintained by Google. It is used for front-end web application development. So basically, it was like traditionally what used to happen is user used to send request to client, then client used to send request to the server. This was the traditional approach. For example, we want to visit any site like example.com, some example like my own blog, that is latestlearn.com. First we used to click on latestlearn.com, then the request used to go from client to the server. This was the traditional approach. But if we want to visit multiple pages, if there are about page in that in the same site, and there are again account pages there, these are the different pages. So for each page, this client server procedure this client and server response and request will keep on going. This will work. This will start. But with AngularJS, it is like first. Client loads initial data from the database. Everything is initially done, and once the request is raised by the user, the client only processes the thing and then send it back. So this is a bit faster. It is a bit faster than the traditional web application. So one thing comes in our mind is when we think about web application, one thing comes is Selenium. Why not Selenium, and why we are using Protractor? The basic idea with Selenium, it is like we are facing a lot of synchronization issues. First, sometimes the test will get passed, but after sometimes it will give an error called stale error, which specifies that that object is not present in the DOM. That is a data, this the HTML code which is present. So we came up with a new option that is called Protractor. So Protractor is a framework which is developed by the AngularJS developers for testing AngularJS application. Next is let's move towards the setup of the Protractor. Everyone is having Node.js, check it by npm /version. So this shows the npm version. So everyone is on the same page. Yeah. And now let's install the Protractor. npm install Protractor.
Does it install globally?
I'm putting it minus it, so it will install globally. So you can save it in the same folder, which the project folder which you are using. Then also it will work, but it will be for that particular folder only. The whatever files are there, that will be revealed. But if you want to run it globally, then you have to put minus it. So
So this starts the installation of protractor. So the dependencies which are required for the protractor will be which are included, that also will download with the protractor version. I have my protractor version installed, so it is showing these two files are getting updated. But for you, there will be a bunch of files installed that are the dependencies which are required for protractor. A bunch of files will be installed. Done with protractor installation?
Yeah.
Yeah? What's going on? See this. The user, your username will be there. After that, the app data and the NPM path will be. You have to put it in the path. And another thing, you have to. Do you want to see it? You just type install npm install protractor -g. It will install it globally. For then the second thing which we are going to work is the BDD approach. That is, we are going to use Cucumber. So to integrate this Cucumber and protractor, we also require Cucumber. So we have to install again the protractor. With protractor, we have to install Cucumber. By options, these are all, these tags are not covered in Selenium, so they came up with protractor as a solution.
So Protractor, now in Protractor, everyone has done with the installation. Now, the difference is because there are new tags which has been introduced in the Angular JS, which are like bind, by binding, by model, and by options. These are the few new tags. For this, there are no special locators which are available in Selenium. So Angular JS has introduced Protractor, and they have also solved this problem by introducing the new locators in Protractor. So everyone, go to your C drive, program files, a user, sorry, users, then your user, then there is a folder called app data. If you can't see app data, then you have to go to view and enable the hidden files. You can see that app data there. Folder called npm, and in npm there is node modules, and in node modules there is Protractor, and in Protractor there is an example, and the main two things which are required for running the Protractor is the config file and the spec file. The config file here works like the main main file which we use in Java, which we use in Selenium to trigger any scripts. It is like a main file. So I will show the config file. This is the config file. In config file, first thing is direct connect. Direct connect is like it will directly hit the browser driver, and there are other more techniques through which we can trigger the Selenium server. Direct connect is used to trigger the Selenium server. Selenium server is like a middleware between test scripts and the our browser. So once that we pass any command, like we tell the browser, tell the through script, we tell that we have to click anything. So this will be directed to the Selenium server. Then Selenium server will then redirect it to the browser. So then browser will perform the action, and then the result will be reverted back to the test script. So it will be stored in the in our result folder. So this is the technique how Protractor works. So in direct connect, we can put, if direct connect is true, then it will connect. There is no need of the Selenium server. It will directly pick up from the Selenium folder which is present in the node module.
there are other more techniques which through which we can directly trigger the Selenium server. Selenium server jar, we have to mention the path of the Selenium server jar here. Selenium address, we can like RC, in Selenium RC we used to we used to make the server up, then we used to connect the take that address, and then we can connect it to through Selenium address. So direct connect, I told you, if we put it true false, then it will directly connect to the browser driver. So next,
in which case do we
most preferable is direct connect.
In which case do we set the direct connect as false?
Direct connect as false. You can, if you are not using direct connect, then it is fine. You can use Selenium address or Selenium jar, server jar. Direct connect false if it's like you are running your thing on locally, so there is no need of Selenium jar file, so it is not necessary that to use direct connect. At that time you can set it false. If you are not having Selenium server jar, it will directly hit the browser driver and it will do its function. Direct connect, then it will, it's like you have to, it will download the jar file, that Selenium server, and it will directly connect to the web browser.
Okay, it will download the jar from the...
Yeah. But what it does is, actually, when we install the protractor only, at that time only the Selenium server and the Chrome driver is downloaded. I will show it. So after protractor and after protractor, you have to put like web driver. Now the web driver is the Selenium standalone jar is getting downloaded, and the Gecko driver and the this one Chrome driver is getting in, downloaded from the from on the, this is getting downloaded, and it will be stored in a folder where. Selenium web driver. See the Selenium standalone server, the Gecko driver, and the Chrome driver is being downloaded from is downloaded, and it is being placed in a Selenium folder. So the next thing,
can you just hold on?
Yeah.
You wrote this command.
Web driver manager update.
Thank you.
we have a channel downloaded, then we can use it.
Can we not place it?
Yeah, we can download it. If you have the Selenium, if you can download the Selenium standalone server, and then you have to make a folder called Selenium, and then place it all your standalone server, your Chrome driver, and Gecko driver there. So then also it will work. So mostly it is like in companies, some of the drivers are drivers we can't download. There are some restrictions. So if we have the drivers before only, then we can place it in the Selenium folder. Then also it will work. So next thing is the capabilities. In capabilities we have to mention the browser name. We can if we mention Chrome, then the Chrome driver will be triggered. If we mention Firefox, then the Firefox driver will be triggered. If there is if we have to use anything other than this, then we have to mention the path, because they are not, these drivers are not being downloaded at the time of WebDriver Manager update. So we have to give the path of these drivers.
So then anywhere like on a system we can download it.
We can give them path. Then next comes the framework selection. Yeah.
Where we have to give the Selenium path?
Selenium address. Framework means the VDD frameworks which we have, that is Jasmine, Mocha, and Cucumber. So it is like Jasmine is the default framework which is included in, which comes with Protractor only. But first, it was like Cucumber was also included, but after 3.0 version, above that version, that Cucumber was removed. And so it is like we have to integration folder was created again by the this Protractor team to integrate Protractor and Cucumber. So the next thing is the spec in which we have to mention the JS file in which we will have a business logic. So whatever page objects is there, then the operations we have to perform, whatever it is there, we have to mention it in the example spec.js. That is the JS file. So then the Jasmine node ops are there, where we can mention the report type. We can mention it is like then the default timeout, which we can mention anything. Which is needed to be loaded at the initial stage can be mentioned in the Jasmine node ops. The required JS file also can be mentioned here. I'll show you. This is the config file for Cucumber, right? Here we are mentioning the browser name, then the capabilities here. But in Cucumber ops, we are mentioning the JS file, folder path, where we have kept the JS file. The format is pretty, means the line by line, if the that statement is pass or fail will be shown in the command prompt.
Basically, this is the Cucumber option.
Yeah, Cucumber options. Yeah, the same. So these are the browsers which are supported by Protractor. These are the frameworks which we use, that is the Jasmine, then the